Good morning, everybody, and this is your S&P 500 day trade setups for today. So, been offline for a week, been busy moving house and having a bit of trouble with connectivity. So you may hear some echoes and things in the background, but at least we have connectivity. So at the moment, you know, last week was pretty much nothing. There was nothing really going on. From my last video last Monday, a week ago, we've basically just ranged, and there is our current range. So two things on the cards for me at the moment. The one is flat top triangle, and the other one is a range. So those are the two levels we need to pay attention to. So we start getting down to the lower time frames. This is where the action happens. And you can see 3 hour, nothing really different to the two levels that I've given you at the moment. But let's just get down to the hour and have a look at what we have here. Okay, so you can see most of last week coming down onto moving averages, finding some support at the moving averages, and then buyer stepping in. So Thursday looked like a bit of a break, and I just want to fine tune this level. There we go. So the first level to the upside that we need to get through is 4716. So the fact that we kind of closed on 4700 is a little bit confusing. You would have expected a weekly close above 4700, but at the moment, that is what we have. Sideways, shouldn't be wanting to trade this anyway, so maybe now that I'm back behind the mic, we may actually get some price action to start indicating moves to the upside. So right now, this may be our trend line, new trend line for support for a break above 4716, 4717. That's probably the area we need to wait for. Break, retest of that, and that should give us an option for some more upside. Alternatively, if we start dropping down and breaking below 4673, then I would expect us more than likely can come and find some support a little bit lower down, somewhere in the region of 4650. So there was a bit of noise last week, but that noise hasn't really impacted the market. And there were some bills, some additional bills that the Senate needs to sign off over the weekend. I haven't read up on that yet, but I'm assuming that that's happened because we are kind of bouncing a little bit. But yeah, I think nothing really in this until we break 4716 or 4717. Break and retest that, continuation to the upside. If we reject this area, then I'd be looking for something on lower time frames to come and test this trend line if you're going to scalp. But I think probably the better advice is stay out of this. Wait for the break, the clear break, the upside for the long. Alternatively, wait for a break of 46.73 area, but also wait for the moving averages to cross over. If you look at the 15 minutes, nothing really in it. Thursday, break up, and then Friday, back below the moving averages. Now we're above them. So sideways, complete confusion. So I'm kind of sit on hands until we start breaking 4717 to the upside. Anyway, that's it for me today. Hope it helps, and we'll be back with you tomorrow morning. Cheers for now.